Welcome back to Head Start. Is it mask on or mask off in Cebu? We have with us Cebu Governor Gwen Garcia. Governor Garcia, good morning.
Good morning, Karen.
All right. Now, Executive Order 16, this has spurred a lot of controversy. The DILG says they do not recognize this order. What is the latest? Are you withdrawing the order or the order stays?
The order stays. Well, I think perhaps Secretary Anyo was not fully informed of the contents of Executive Order 16. It merely states that in open, well-ventilated areas, the use of masks shall be optional. Optional is the operative word here. Those who wish to continue wearing their masks, by all means, they can do that. Mm. However, we need to rationalize the use of these face masks. If you are in a well-ventilated, open environment, and especially when the use of face masks already is an added burden, like you're walking on the street under a very hot day, or you are biking or jogging, or even when you wish to avail of the beneficial benefits of sea air or fresh air up in the mountains, are we going to continue using these face masks? I know that the Department of Health has made specific instances where you may take this off, and that is when you are eating. So are we going to ask the police to time when specifically a person may take off the face mask while he's eating, while he's chewing, and while he's swallowing? Is that still allowed, or should he now put back his face masks? You know, it has reached the point of, shall we say, ridiculousness. When we shall be requiring everyone to be wearing their face mask 24 hours a day. Of course, perhaps when you're sleeping, you may take that off. Let me repeat, EO 16 merely rationalizes the use of face masks. It's something that we should have long recognized. I know that there was a threat of apprehending these people who would be walking out in open environments. Why was this not ever done during the campaigns when hundreds of thousands were gathered and many of them without face masks? Even during caravans with people lining up the streets without the face masks. And then suddenly, because I have an executive order, there is the threat of apprehension. By the way, I know that Cebu City tried to do that. That was during perhaps last year when they really wanted to enforce the wearing of face masks. And well, there were just so many who were not wearing for their own reasons outside. They were hard put to on where to put these violators. They would be put in jail. And that certainly would defeat the theory that we need to maintain social distancing when hundreds would be cramped up in cells that are inadequate to, you know, fine or to put in these violators. So let's put a little sense here. I even said, you know, in crowded areas, we highly recommend the wearing of face masks. Inside air-conditioned, closed environments, the wearing of face masks is required, but I see pictures of certain officials inside air-conditioned places not wearing face masks. Why? Is that taking off a face mask when you're being photographed one of the exceptions that is allowed by the DOH? And by the way, that is an exception, including eating and drinking.
Governor,
does that make us less vulnerable to the so-called virus when we're eating, drinking, or taking photos, so we may take off our face mask?
Okay. Governor, sino po ang dapat sundan ng Cebu PNP? The DILG has ordered the PNP to apprehend and arrest those without masks. The Cebu PNP is taking your side. Sino po ba dapat sundan po ng police?
I believe that the Cebu PNP is on the right track here. Even the IATF guidelines, and I hope that they would read their own guidelines. specify in several occasions that these guidelines need to be supported with the local ordinances in the respective local government units. Unless these are so done, then these guidelines remain as advisories. So on what basis will the PNP apprehend? What law would this so-called unfaced mask walking in the open environments violators be violating? We don't have these ordinances in the province of Cebu. In fact, by my executive order, when there was a time when they were exacting fines, 500 pesos for every violator, I said that is anti-poor. The only people that you would apprehend would be those walking on the streets because they cannot afford to ride in expensive cars. And 500 pesos would already mean perhaps a whole week of food for their families. Besides, it's room for corruption. If you make 10 apprehensions, is that duly resisted? And how can we be sure that from the 10 apprehensions for which you would gain you would collect 5,000 pesos? Are we really sure that all the 10 violations would be reported? So in the province of Cebu, the non-wearing of face mask is not against the law or against any local ordinance. If the police would be apprehending these people, they might be accused of illegal arrest. You know, it is so easy to just release statements, but let us do so under the existing laws. Let us not go ahead and, you know, make threatening remarks without fully studying. Besides, Karen, the IATF guidelines, ito yun, oh.
Yeah, yeah.
This is their latest. Basahin naman nila ito. Okay. Andito sa Section 5 of issued June 4, 2022. Under Alert Level 2, we are under Alert Level 2. Section 5, Guidelines for Areas Under Alert Level 2. This is number 3. The following establishments shall be allowed, so on and so forth. There is a list of activities and establishments allowed to operate or that are allowed. But it's very clear, very, very clear. Provided further, there is no objection from the local government unit where these activities may take place. This specifically recognizes the autonomy of the local government units. The IATF EID was created by virtue of presidential decree 168, then issued by President Noynoy Aquino. This IATF task force must at all times consult with the local government unit.
Okay.
And under the law, this is a law. This is not some threat by someone who just wants to, exercise his power. Section 105 of the local government.
Yeah, you actually cited that, Section 105 of the local government code. So I wanted to ask you, you believe that the IATF and even the DILG is out of its depth already? This is beyond their jurisdiction. There's no legal basis.
There is no legal basis, and I will stand for that.
All right.
No legal, let me qualify that. There is no legal basis for apprehending people that are outside in open, well-ventilated areas, not wearing face masks, if they choose, if they wish to continue wearing face masks, that is their choice.
Okay.
However, let me be very clear also, and the PNP has stated that we do require the wearing of face masks inside closed air-conditioned environments, and the PNP has stated that they will see to it that this is implemented. Well, I am seeing pictures. It's good that this did not happen in the province of Cebu, but I am seeing pictures of officials inside air-conditioned environments, the air-conditioned very clear at the back, with their face masks off. If this would happen in the province of Cebu, then certainly the PNP can ask them to put on their face masks.
Oo.
By the way, I do not ask.
Pero in Cebu, you cannot apprehend whether or not you are wearing a face mask, right? There is no apprehension.
That's right. That's right. Because I had long ago issued an executive order which stated, do not apprehend these people. Give them face masks. Mm. Let us not make this punitive. Instead, let us make it easier for the many, many, many who cannot afford buying new face masks every day. For the many who need, who sometimes find it hard to breathe, walking under the heat of the sun. Mm. And, you know, some of these people, kawawa eh.
Okay.
Alam mo naman
Governor,
talaga, hindi na makabili ng face mask.
Oo.
Their face masks are so dirty na, and they recycle and recycle it.
Okay. Governor, some have asked, it's 2 weeks to go before President Duterte steps down from office, and the DILG actually mentions that it's President Duterte's stance that the mask mandate should remain until the end of his term. So ang tanong ng ilan, ba't di na lang daw hinintay ni Governor Garcia na bumaba si Pangulong Duterte and then actually issue your executive order?
It's just, you know, I think it is something that the DILG must explain. Mm. If you would notice, Karen, during the Independence Day rides in Luneta Park, yes, the president was wearing a face mask at the start, but there are pictures also of him taking off his face mask. So what is this? Mm. Is the DILG saying that the president says one thing and does another thing? It's very easy to say, you know, to drop the name of the president. Mm. Sa akin lang, let's not be hypocrites here. Mm. Alam naman natin eh, kahit tayo, when we are outside, sometimes it's really so hard to breathe na, tinatanggal natin yan. Mm. This is already an existing reality. Eh bakit pa magmamaang-maangan pa tayo? Mm. Eh kahit nga, during the campaign, bakit wala kayong ginawa? Mm. Bakit wala kayong apprehensions? Even though the COMELEC resolution was very strict against the taking of selfies, against the taking out of face mask. If this were to be, you know, there are certain regulations that are unimplementable. Mm. If we were to apprehend hundreds of thousands, saan yan natin ilalagay? Mm. So let's put some sense. Kaya nga sabi ko, let's rationalize it.
Oo. Okay, Governor, you are stepping into the new normal, living with COVID. Ang tanong ko po dito, what will you do to increase the uptake of booster shots, which seems to be a problem in the whole Philippines? And do you have fears that when people stop wearing their masks, because if you make it optional, the fears of, I guess, the Department of Health is, syempre, if it's optional, you wouldn't want to wear a mask outdoors. And that might cause the spread of COVID, and we have new variants.
Okay, booster shots first.
Okay.
We have been strongly supporting the vaccination program. All of our municipalities, all of our cities, through their rural health units, have available vaccination. Kami, we have this caravan of provincial government services. And part of that, aside from medical services, veterinary services, part of that is walk-in vaccination. So, as I said then, let vaccination be a matter of choice. Noon, hindi ako vaccinated. So people would say, kaya nga, you're defending the unvaccinated because hindi ka vaccinated. Well, I have myself vaccinated.
Oh.
I'm waiting for my booster shot.
Okay.
But still, I would defend a person's right to choose to get vaccinated or not. Unless you make vaccination mandatory.
Yeah. But how were the numbers in Cebu, Governor? How were your numbers in terms of two shots for vaccination and booster? Kamusta po?
I think we should ask the Department of Health about that. I don't closely monitor that. I have other concerns that are more important to me.
Mm-mm. Okay, but would you say that it's safe? I think that's important with your executive order to make non-wearing of masks optional. Do you feel it's already safe?
Eto na, we've had the campaign. People were not wearing masks. Nakikita mo naman yan eh. You have footages and kilometers of footages of all of these rallies from all political camps, ang dami-dami walang nagmamask. Mm-mm. The campaign, what? It ended with the election May 9. Ilang weeks na? Mm-mm. Ano na tayo ngayon? June.
June 13. The numbers ayun. Remain the same.
Nagkaroon na ba tayo ng terrifying surges in the number of positives right after the campaign? So, is it safe? When can we ever be 100% safe, not just from COVID, but from all other infectious diseases?
Okay.
This is not a perfect world. There will always be diseases. But let us temper our reaction and our way of addressing the challenge. Let us not bring it to ridiculous, unimplementable levels. If we are going to apprehend, if we were to implement COMELEC resolution which prohibited selfies, prohibited the milling around of several people, shaking hands and all, if we were to fully implement that, meron pa ba tayong jail that could take in all of us? Okay. All of those that violated that?
Governor,
so that is why.
Yeah.
Governor, hindi nga natin ma-implement eh. Yeah. Yes, Karen.
Governor, I know you have another interview with Kabayan. So my last question is, what is your message to DILG Secretary Eduardo Anyo? Because he is taking you head on.
Oh, I don't wish to take him head on. I don't need to. You just read my executive order. Perhaps I would like to think that you reacted without reading fully my executive order. Compare it with existing IATF resolutions so that you may understand what we're doing here in Cebu. There is also, since you're the Secretary of the Interior and Local Government, what we call the Local Government Code of 1991 or Republic Act 7116. As Secretary of the Interior and Local Government, perhaps it might be good to read Section 105. Regarding direct national supervision and control by the Secretary of Health in cases of epidemics, pestilence, and other widespread public health dangers. The Secretary of Health, upon direction of the President and in consultation with the local government unit concerned, temporarily assume direct supervision and control over health operations in any local government unit for the duration of the emergency, but in no case exceeding a cumulative period of 6 months.
Yeah.
With the concurrence of the local government unit concerned, the period for such direct national control and supervision may be extended. All Let right. us respect local autonomy. This is the law, not some guideline. A guideline is a guideline until it is supported by local ordinance.
On that note, Cebu Governor Gwen Garcia, thank you. I appreciate it that you made it to Headstart today. Thank you very much, ma'am.
Thank you, Karen.
We're gonna